Fast and the Furious. Ja Rule or one, yeah, yeah. It's time for me.
Dark cold hotel room and the air. on June 8th. There's Juan. And we are in going to the police center.
Ask you some questions about legal street racing.
Legal?
Illegal.
Okay.
What experience do you have with illegal street racing?
Okay, I've been a police officer for 23 years. Okay, coming up August, be 20 years here. 17 of those years were, actually more than that. 20 years was in the field as a patrol officer, and now 5.5 years on a motor. A motor officer strictly deals with traffic, okay? Specifically with street racing, besides all the different laws pertaining to the operation of vehicles on the street, I've been through courses specifically directed at street racing per se in a roundabout way, and it was called a dragnet class. Dragnet is a unit down in San Diego City Police Department that about 8 years ago, the problem became very intense down there, so they made a special unit to deal with the issues surrounding that. Okay, they became the experts in California. They put together a training course for that, and in fact, they've gone throughout the state giving that training to other officers so they can enforce or use actually the laws better in a different direction for street racing other than just the speeding, the actual race itself. There are other issues that can be dealt with.
So what is actually considered to be illegal racing?
Legal?
Illegal.
Okay. When you're talking about racing, you think of two cars, correct? But in the vehicle code, when you talk about racing or a speed contest or exhibition of speed, it doesn't take two. It's only one. It's speed or time and distance. So if you're, for instance, as simple as one car at a stoplight turns green and he just burns it out across the intersection, then shuts it off. Guess what? I have a crime. And that could be exhibition of speed. Okay? It could be speed contest if I see somebody clocking in. Okay? Or reckless driving, depending on what transpired through that. Is it a race? Well, it could be a race against time. It could be a race like in a road course, etc. What we generally think about is two guys in a car, whether they're already moving in a rolling start or from a dead stop, and two go down the street. That's what normally you think of as a street race, but it doesn't have to be.
And what are the consequences for doing these illegal actions?
Well, it's if you start from the very beginning, if you are seen and stopped, the least of the consequence could be a warning. Okay? Could be. All right? The next step would be a ticket. We don't do written warnings here. Okay? Some agencies in Southern California do written warnings. It's everything on the ticket but warning. I don't understand what the worth of that is, but it's there. But we don't do that. A citation for an infraction. A citation for a misdemeanor. All the way up to, I arrest you, you can go to jail, and I take your car. And I take your car for 30 days. And in that case, there is no early release on the car. If I arrest you, whether I take you to county jail or whether I issue you a citation for certain sections, that's a speed contest, exhibition, or reckless driving, out of all those three, I still have the authority to take and impound your car for 30 days. When that happens, the owner of the car is responsible for the fees here at the police department, which generally come out to about $300, and then the storage, the tow and storage fee, for the 30-day impound, which is anywhere from $1,000 to $1,500.
What are some actions being initiated to deter these illegal activities?
Well, in areas like that, they do have stings. They do have informants that will say, yep, okay. These car clubs, they're not the sharpest tools in the shed. They'll actually advertise on the internet. Hey, we're going to race down here Friday night. Gee whiz, we actually have the internet. We can look at that. So we'll show up in force, with force, and we'll shut down the whole area. If you're in that area when that happens, guess what? You're getting at least a ticket. You may be getting your car towed, etc. When Ontario does sweeps like that, they're talking hundreds and hundreds of arrests. Okay, and an arrest meaning a ticket is given in most cases. Okay, on our level, because we don't have that huge problem like they do, hypothetically, I see the souped-up Honda Acura going down the street. Okay, by the way it's equipped, by the way it looks, by the way I hear it, etc. Okay, there's a section in the vehicle code that says if I have a reasonable cause to believe that a car has been modified, I have the authority to stop the car and do an inspection of the car. Okay, so I see the car, he has several items on that that lead me to believe that, yep, this looks like a person who has modified his car for the purpose of street racing to get that edge, get higher performance out of it to beat my competitor. Okay, I stop him, I do the inspection, yep, 9 times out of 10 stops, you betcha, the car's been modified some way, whether it's been lowered, whether the exhaust has been changed, okay, whether the tires are too skinny for the car, won't hold the car. That's where I use the rest of the vehicle code to enforce that. Are they street racing? No, they are not. Could they be? Well, the car is modified to get that extra performance. Does that necessarily make them a street racer? No, it doesn't. However, when you start looking at the other issues involved, and specifically emission controls, okay, every car made today has emission controls on it. Why? So we can breathe longer. Okay, when you start modifying anything to do with the performance of that motor, you've messed with the emission controls.
So what do you think can help like reduce the problem of street racing? Any other solutions?
Maturity. I think from the advent of the automobile, there have been people who want to push the envelope, have performed to their peak. Okay, that happens to be tied with youthfulness. How is that going to change? Like I said, when they grow up and they understand that the risk that they take when they engage in that type of behavior may not necessarily be worth the end result.
What is your opinion on like legal racing, about that issues of like legal racing in other places?
Great idea. The thing is, like California Speedway, wonderful, beautiful new facility, etc. The downside to it is, if you wanted to take your car out there to race, you're going to have to jump through all their hoops. You're going to have your car equipped safely the way they want it. You have to drive the way they want it. Why? Because it's their property. Okay, so that's kind of the downside. But it's all designed for, the rules are designed there to protect you. Okay, and to another degree to keep everybody on the same level. Okay, so if you wanted to do that, wonderful. It's just not like, hey, we're going to go do this, and you go. Now, there is some forethought to it because you have to have your car equipped a certain way, have a certain safety equipment that will allow you to race there. So it's not like you can just spur the moment, go out there with your buddy and race. You need to do find out, well, what do I need to have? Do I need to have certain certificates, insurance, equipment? Do I have to have a helmet? Do I have to have racing harnesses in my car? Any of these things. Okay? The big thing that I would tell folks, and I've been doing this a long time, and this is something I hear when I stop cars that are equipped with things for performance, etc. I hear these two things. Well, I show my car. Okay, great. Then it should be in an enclosed trailer when you're pulling it from your house to the show. While you're driving it, it needs to be legal. Same thing with racing. Okay? Well, I race this car at the track. Great. You're not going to drive it on the city streets equipped that way. Okay? Because a lot of times they're unsafe. They'll need to be safe and equipped for the track. That may not necessarily mean they're safe for the city streets.
Do you think the glamorization of illegal street racing in Hollywood provoke more people to race, give them a false image?
Yes. Yeah. Look what happened after Fast and Furious. Everybody wanted to be, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, less so with number two. Less so.
Very much.
My pleasure.
time to sink or swim. The beast inside is hearing me right underneath my skin.
It's like a paranoid looking up on my back. It's like a whirlwind inside of my head. It's like a can't stop what I'm living within. It's like the face inside is right beneath my skin.
I know I've got a face in me, points out all my mistakes to me. You got a face on the inside too. Your paranoia is probably worse. I don't know what set me off first, but I know what I can't stand. Everybody acts like the fact of the matter is I can't add up to what you can. But everybody has a face that they hold inside. Face that awakes when I close my eyes. Face that watches every time.
So Chris, I also hear that you're aspiring to be a super male model. How do you think this is going to conflict with your career as a street racer? I mean, juggling, you know, super modeling by day and racing by night?
Yeah, it is true. I'm well, look at that, two SIs.
Oh.
Yeah, recently got an award for being most potential for a supermodel, but... You know, street racing and modeling do go well together, as you've seen in import tuner magazines. However, the male modeling scene, I'm going to make the breakthrough. So, you know, who can resist?
I agree. So, Chris, it seems like you've got the perfect life going here. You know, you have your lucrative super modeling job by day. And I also hear you got a pretty hot girlfriend.
Yeah, I just flip the camera around. Come on.
I don't have my face on.
So do.
Oh, here's the other film crew. So Chris, have you ever had an encounter with the police? I heard you guys had a rough time with them yesterday.
Well, yeah, we had a little scratch with them yesterday, you know? A little. Intervening with the law, you know, they don't like what we do, obviously, because
riding on the sidewalk and whatnot,
you know, endangering public lives, but it's my exhilaration, you know? Everything has a cost.
Oh, I see. That's deep. It's real deep. Well, it seems like you guys mean business. Kids, don't try this at home.
Looks like we're making a lane change here.
Tricky
move.
Tricky maneuver.
Hopefully that, see that? That's what we like to call the cut off from the right. Very skilled maneuver. It takes many years of practice.
See that?
Skilled driver, very skilled.
So we just left the freeway, no man's land. Now entering rural America.
Another race, another pink slipper.
Yes, in the world of street racing, they mean business.
Funny is, the police station is right here. Film a police station right here.
Huh.
On the right. Right by this Carl's Jr. That's the library. And right here's the police station. Film the police station.
Okay, where is the police station?
Right here. Anaheim Police. See, I race down this street all the time. Because the cops can't catch us.
These guys laugh in the face of danger. Chris laughed for me.
Police?
And I'm sure you, the viewers, can see, street racing is no smooth ride. It's a lot of bumpiness, obstacles, and lane changing. So Christopher, how long have you been street racing?
Since I first got my car. This car's been a race car from day one. And that's been about, well, I'd say, 2 years. I started driving illegally. You know, I had a lot of friends in the scene, so, you know, they got me involved in the fixing up cars, and pretty soon it just became my hobby. You know, racing was my own thing. Took it from my friends.
Well, if I may say, you are born to race. got the whole fleet here, ready to rock and roll.
You're a party animal?
Why, indeed I am.
That's what they're looking
for. You see that face? That is the face of exhilaration. That's our other cameraman over there. His name is Cornelius.
My engine's not
stopped. Wave your hand, Cornelius. Ah, oh, he's too busy.
What, man? Looking at my girl? Huh? Thank you, man. Huh? Pink slips.
Window communication.
It's a secret language. You gotta learn to talk with the racers. If I tried this with any other normal driver like this man on my right, get a shot of him. And I told him he got off the wrong exit on the freeway. I'll just follow you guys.
Just go to Chapman.
I'll follow you guys.
No, look at these fools right here.
See Chapman, but
we'll what kind of racer wears glasses? Good one.
Tell them?
Go to State College. Make a right, and then go
make a left. To a stop at another red light. Chris would like to say a few words.
Yeah, I smoked him.
He did.
Happens all the time. You know. Never get tired of the sweet taste of victory.
Racing really takes its toll on you at 3 a.m., huh, Chris?
Well, we've been scoping out a good race site for about an hour and a half or so.
It's
about 2 a.m. We started about midnight. I'd say about 2 hours we've been looking for a good spot to race. Mm-hmm. You know, but there's a lot of people out here tonight. It must be some huge party or some premiere going on, you know, so a lot of people still running around. But at this time of night, you know, it really gets you. I haven't had my caffeine tonight. No coffee.
But you know what, Chris? Cops gotta sleep sometime. And when they do, there we are, racing. Like true warriors. Yeah. What a bunch of troopers.
Amen. Whoa! There's a pedestrian. They always get the right of way.
Oh, pedestrians, right away. Remember that. Christopher Gardotto means business, ladies and gentlemen.
Race car.
My eyes are...
That's the green light.
Mysteriously.
At the green light. We're going at the green light.
Shadowed.
Goodbye. Ben! At the green light!
What green light?
The green light behind us.
We go?
Yeah. One, two, three!
So Chris, what do you have to say about that incident that just happened? I'm sure you feel very disappointed right now.
Disappointed.
You know, but these things happen. Would you like to express your feelings about it?
Just gotta wait till the next race. You know, can always do it again. As long as I got my car.
What's that? What's that I hear? Ah, that's the voice of optimism.
don't act the fool while we up in